this damage. The way I feel came. I feel the city every day, somebody dying. Leaving a mama to raise a boy, but with no father. And every young is stuck in a trap.
Sitting here with my man, introduce yourself to the people, man.
Man, I go by the name Leek Coleman.
Yeah.
That's on all platforms, Leek underscore Coleman. That's LeekColeman. Leek Coleman, man. R&B artist from Uptown, Wayne Ave. Shout out to Wayne Ave.
Yeah. So talk to us, man. What's the goal, man? I know a lot of people doing music out here. Some people just want the likes. Some people just want the money without the fame. You know, what's the goal for Leek Coleman?
I mean,
man?
For me, is more so like is a passion. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? Like is something I love to do. It's something I do in my spare time when I'm free. If I find myself doing it, even if I don't want to do it. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? So it's kind of like something that I naturally do every single day. Yeah. You know what I mean? So. Mm-hmm. And it's fun.
Yeah.
And you know, at the end of the day, when you're doing something that you love to do and it's fun at the same time,
mm-hmm.
and it comes out with you making good music,
yeah.
why not do it?
Yeah, yeah, if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
So what type of singers inspire you?
When I growing up, I listened to a lot of different artists, being as though like I got a big family. Like I got a real big family. Like and my mom got 9 kids, so you know, at the end of the day, like I'm the middle child, so I'm like dead smack in the middle. So I got older sisters and stuff, they don't listen to a million artists from Usher to Trey Songz to R. Kelly to the Omarions, the B2Ks, the whole, mm-hmm. like, you see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I done got a whiff of like all different type of genres of music basically like growing up, but I honestly could say more so like the Trey Songz wave.
Okay.
Like that was like Trey was like a bull. Like it kind of like, I'm not really into the whole R&B-ish, like with your shirt off, with the, yeah,
mm-hmm. yeah.
you know what I mean? Like, I ain't really more so into that.
Yeah.
So Trey kind of like made it cool. Mm-hmm. Like, you know what I mean? Like Trey kind of like made it cool. Like he did his thing kind of like business attire, kind of like grown and sexy type look, mm-hmm. like grown man status yeah. type tone. Like, you see what I'm saying? So he kind of like.
So would you do it if they told you to do it? Like, yo, get up there, take your shirt off.
And start doing like spins.
No.
B2K kicks.
No.
And,
the crazy yep. part is I wouldn't do it. Like, cause it's not me.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I mean? And me trying to do something that's not me, it ain't gonna work.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like I could try to go as hard as I can trying to do something else, but you know, it just won't work for me. With directions, with instructions, it just won't work.
So talk to us about your projects, man. What you got coming up, what you got already circulating. You know what I mean? If people want to find the videos, people want to see, you know what I mean, your work, you know, how do they get a hold of your work?
They could go ahead, like I said before, all platforms, Spotify, iTunes, Apple Music, just type in Leek Coleman. Again, that's LEEK underscore Coleman, COLEMAN. As far as the Apple Music go, you don't know, no underscores, just straight LEEK. YouTube, same thing, Leek Coleman, you type it in, a bunch of stuff should pop up as far as like that's featuring me, you know, and some of our artists, so, mm-hmm. you know. Instagram, same thing, LEEK underscore Coleman, you know what I mean? So, you know, y'all can find me like that.
So how do you describe your style? Because, I mean, previously, before we went on air, you talked about, you don't talk about guns, drugs, and salacious
like,
nights with women.
My style.
We need you to talk about guns, drugs, and salacious nights with women. Because I want to live vicarious through
it's
music.
Like inspiration.
Yeah, it's definitely inspirational.
I mean, like with me, I kind of like what I like the type of wave I be on. I feel like it's different.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like I feel like I don't sound like nobody. You can't compare me to nobody. So I feel like my style is kind of like unique a little bit. Like mm-hmm. you know what I mean? I kind of like got my own sound. Like if you listen to me, I don't sound like no P&B rock.
Yeah.
I don't sound like nobody. Like. It's not really nobody that you could compare me to, you know. Mm-hmm. That's my personal opinion, but it's not too many people you could compare me to. Like, you know mm-hmm. what I mean? So my joint is kind of like, and another thing is I could kind of touch a lot of different fan bases. Like I said before, I do got a tape. It's called This Is The Tape. Y'all could go ahead, look that up. Apple Music, go ahead and tune in. It's more R&B-ish. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? Like, so it's kind of like different lanes that I could step in. Like when I want to be, I could be R&B-ish.
Mm-hmm.
When I want to be, I could go ahead and get y'all the street track. When I want to be, I could go ahead and get y'all the pop. Like, you see what I'm saying? Like it's a different type of, like an eras of music that I could touch. And like when I say that, you know, you got like some artists, they kind of like box they self in.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know what I mean? Like you got mm-hmm. like a, for example, me speaking like an Ed Sherman or something, you see what I'm saying? Like, yeah. I don't hear him making like no trap type song. Yeah. I don't hear him making like no, like kind of like even R&B-ish. His is more so like a pop gospel yeah. type. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. it's like around there, and he'll never like step out of that box. But you know, time wait for nobody. So yeah. at the end of the day, the era is changing. So I try not to box myself in and be able to like touch every fan base, every little genre of music that I can touch, you know what I mean? So I think that's more so like what makes me unique.
So do you have any baby making music on there? Or do young boys even use baby making music?
Nah,
that?
No, they
fucking a little dirt and all that.
Cause back in the day, man, we had like, you know what I mean? You come in and you knew what was popping. Chick having a little bit of Jodeci, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
some Purple Rain or some shit like that.
Casey, boy.
It's so crazy, like that's kind of what's missing. That's what's missing.
She be butt ass naked for some future.
Yeah.
Yeah, you probably just like the best chewy you ever had the future. You be like, well, damn. I never thought a future like some romance shit. I'm gonna play this shit again.
Cause I remember back in the day, it's like, yeah. you know, cause we dudes, we ain't gonna tell each other.
Right.
But it's times you go in there and she got that slow music on. You're like, damn. You don't know how to react. Cause yeah. you're like, I'm a young man. I know what to do, but you like, man. How am I supposed to be smooth with this? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Them times definitely change. You know, I think more so like. Now it's not a whole lot of baby making music. It's not, because R&B is not what it used to be. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So R&B, to me, like technically, is not really R&B.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know what I mean? Like the old R&B kind of like gave you that feel, mm-hmm. kind of like that chill, and it was more slowed up. Like R&B now is kind of more so like R&B rap.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah. It's not really R&B. It's not really R&B no more.
So how do you feel about that?
I mean, it's a win-lose situation.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like I said before, I could make songs and actually touch, you know, like touch like that fan base that really want R&B, but at the same time, is you either gonna win or you gonna lose because yeah. the era don't wanna hear it. You see what I'm saying? So if you go ahead and you making your little sexy video and all that with your shirt off and you doing the whole, that's more so like a bit.
Yeah.
Like, you see what I'm saying? Like, and as far as me, like as a person, like, that's not me as a person, but me as an artist, I know how to do it.
Yeah.
Me as a person is not me. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But I can do it.
So, I need a story. I need a story about how you used your singing to get some draws. Because I know you did. Like, I mean, I know if I could sing, I would try it. You know what I mean?
Listen, I can't sing and I tried it.
So come on, you gotta come clean. Right, come clean. I know you've done sung to a chick before.
Is you know, at the end of the day, you know, females always hit you with the, oh, you gonna sing to me? Oh, can I play in your hair while you sing to me? It's crazy because I just kind of like got a DM like 2 days ago.
You know,
kind of like, yeah, can I braid your hair and you could just sing to me? You know, for granted, I left it on red, but yeah, so you know, but.
You ain't telling me the story. You talking about, nah, he talking about a time that 2 days ago, somebody propositioned.
You know, so,
don't get on here and get the red.
Yeah, so you know,
want you to red.
You got a curve, John.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
Skirt.
You
know what I'm saying? So you know.
Fuck him up. Nah, so. I guess, like, you know, before we wrap this whole joint up, I guess I just want to know, like, you know, what artists you see yourself working with, you want to work with, your dream of working with, and, like, you know, what's the ideal position for you when this whole thing's over, when it's all said and done, and you're sitting in your 50-room mansion with all the dark skin and light skin and caramel skin thoughts. You know what I mean? Like, what's the goal? Like, when it's all said and done, like,
When it's said and done, I just kind of, like, want to be able to, like, say I did it my way.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like I said before, I'm not a big fan of, like, riding waves and doing whatever people do. And, like, you know, we had a conversation before, and we had talked about more so, like, the sounds and the people who sound alike and who sound similar.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to go ahead and be able to do things my way and be successful at it. And then, you know, at the end of the day, I could be proud within myself. You know what I mean? Like, I could sit back, and when it's all said and done, I could say, I did it my way, and it actually came out successful. Like, you know what I mean? So,
So when you do make it, you telling me you got like 9 brothers and sisters you gotta break bread with?
Yeah.
You better than me.
Yeah.
You know
what I mean? You see what I'm saying? Yeah.
Gingerbread, man.
Like,
you know what I mean?
We was all tight. Like, you know what I mean? Like, yeah. Like growing up in my mom's crib, 3-story house, 9 of us all living in there. You know that come with a bunch of arguments, a bunch of fights, a bunch of who touched my chicken wing platter. I was in the refrigerator. Yeah. You know, like it's a bunch of times like that. But at the same time, you know, some people actually like don't like being in that environment. It's so crazy that I kind of like love it. So when I kind of like be by myself, I kind of like miss like being at my mom's crib. Like my mom's crib is like the spot. Like you know what I mean? Like that's where it's lit at. Like oh yeah, you going to mommy house? Yeah, I'm going to mommy house. Like cause that's where all the memories at. That's where everything at. You know what I mean? Like ain't. Nothing like home for real.
Yeah, not
like,
at all.
You know what I mean? So
not at all. Can't put a price tag on home.
I just dropped it last week. Probably going on 2 weeks. Y'all could go ahead and check that out. It's called just type in Leek Coleman, XXX. It'll pop up. But it's more so a video that was more like heartfelt. Like you know what I mean? The story behind it was like real deep. If you watch it, a lot of people will be able to to relate to it. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people like from the hoods or whatever the case that don't really got a voice that, you know, sometimes if people talk about that, most people don't really want to hear that because it's all like the same story. Mm-hmm. Like everybody got a struggle. It's like, oh yeah, dang, what's your struggle? Oh, what's your struggle? So some people kind of like just go over it. So I just more so knowing that I got like somewhat some type of platform, I just wanted to go ahead and make a video and basically like put it out there to the public and speak on it because I know there's a lot of people that's like, you know, going through that at the end of the day. And, you know, sometimes people come at me and they look at me different or sideways and think like everything good and gravy with me and it ain't. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I'm going through the same stuff that everybody else going through. Like, you know what I mean? So I kind of just wanted to go ahead and get people my story, my side, and go ahead and shoot a video and, you know, bring everything to life. As far as the video go, I got my mom in the video. Like, that's my actual mom in the joint. And if you watch it, you can see there's a lot of feelings on her face. Yeah. Like, you know what I mean? Because the things and the topics that I was talking about was like real touching as far as my family go. You know, I lost a real close family member that lived in my household growing up with me and my mom and everybody. You know, do so to the murder, like murder out here in the streets or whatever the case. So I basically put that in the song. And what I was singing about was more so the situation. You know what I mean? And then everything that has to take place after that take place. You know, when you lose someone or whatever the case, there's a lot of stuff that still has to get done behind closed doors. Like, rent still gotta get paid. Yeah. If you going half with you and your wife and something happened to you, the whole burden on her.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? So it's just a whole, it's just a lot of reality, real deep stuff behind it. Like, you know what I mean? So, and like I said before, if you watch it, my mom was actually like tearing in the joint. Like, it's like real tears, you know, because it was heartfelt and it was our story. So me shooting it, I'm in the crib shooting it, my niece right there, and more so that was her father. You see what I'm saying? So she basically like looking at the video kind of like, dang, that's deep. She walk off, she actually come back crying. You know what I mean? Like, but at the same time, like I said, I just wanted to go ahead and get the people something real, kind of like in close, like up close, up close and personal in your face. You see what I'm saying? Like, and basically everything was just like 100% real, like the location. You know what I mean? Like, you could go ahead, you could see the pictures and everything. Like, you know what I mean? So everything is kind of like dead smack in your face, but it's like a real situation. You see what I'm saying? And a lot of people wouldn't know that. You see what I'm saying? I shared it with y'all. And now at the end of the day, you know, I'm like open arms to share it with the world. But at the same time, like, that's my story. You see what I'm saying? So it's just me telling my story.
I think a lot of people going to respect your vulnerability right there. Just, you know, bring yourself up to the world. I think, a lot of artists that become successful put themselves in a position where they, you know, become vulnerable for their fans, and that make you more relatable. You know, it's easy to be like the super gangster or the super lover behind the microphone.
Yeah, that's
really
true.
Different than that. Then it's a little bit different to give everybody a piece of you, and then they feeling like, well, yeah, I know him. Like, I know him through his music. I relate to him through his music.
I mean, I think that definitely works out better because you don't have to keep up the facade. You know what I mean? You, as long as you yourself, you know what I mean? You don't have to worry about, oh, I gotta act this way when I go out, I gotta be this particular way. It's like, this is me and this is how I am, and you don't accept it. And it seems like it seems like that's working more now because there's been so many people faking for so long.
Yeah.
It's like now people like to see some realness.
That's why I love DMX, man.
Without the crack.
With the crack. crack DMX, man. Vulnerable, man.
But yeah, that's what it is. It's more so like another level of me connecting with my fans. Yep. Like I can always go in there and just make good music. Like I could give them good music, but as far as like speaking on situations that I've been through, or if I wanted to go ahead and make a song more so about something that I know, I mean somebody that I know, and like a situation that they've been through, you know what I mean? It's still real life situations, and it's stuff that I'm pretty sure like a lot of people could relate to.
Yep.
And like you said, like a pinpoint more so the whole vulnerable thing. A lot of people don't want to be vulnerable on when cameras is on, you know what I mean? They don't want to talk about the stuff that's really going on, what's really happening. They rather go here, you know what I'm saying? Like you got this image, so you put on this platform.
Yep.
So everybody think everything is okay and you balling and you doing this and you doing that. And it's just like, no, you know, I got real life situations going on just like y'all. Like you see what I'm saying? So, you know, at the end of the day, that was like real cool for me to more so go ahead and touch my fan base and connect and be vulnerable for them. You know, so
that's good shit.
So all I gotta say is, you know what I mean? I mean, you do make it big.
Come back.
Just let come back and let us get some tickets. You know
let
man?
Us be in the video too, cause I need some of your groupies.
100%. We might have to go ahead and shoot a vid. And
this guy, he got a couple homies on the side that's already trying to catch the shit.
Nah, they gonna get the groupies on the way up. Just send me the groupies on the way down.
You know what? They can send you the old head groupies.
No, I want all.
You want the young bucks? Though?
Listen, man. If she 21. Shoot up, check rock. You know what I'm saying?
Yo, man, we definitely appreciate you coming through.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, appreciate y'all. Appreciate you, man.
Best of luck to everything you do, you know what I mean? And
come back, nigga.
Oh, for sure. I'll definitely be back.
You get ready to drop that next project, come back. And don't be afraid to bring the groupies.
100%.
We are pro groupies.
I'm a happily married man.
We can pack this joint.
I don't want any groupies.
Let's pack it.
This is my guy.
Let's pack it.
We are pro groupie.
You are pro groupie.
There we go. We are pro groupie in this establishment.
Yeah.
Bring it.
Yeah. We bringing them through here.
There we go.
We bringing them through here.
I ain't got nothing to do with it.
I should say, oh, baby boy, all up and through here.
You know we bringing them in here.
Bring them through. There we go.